Hello my dear students, welcome you back. It is the fifth video lecture on unit number 5. In last video lecture we have discussed what is the data backup. In this video we are going to discuss how that backup is recovered. Okay, so 5.5 database recovery, and there are two techniques of database recovery. After watching this video, student can easily explain what is the database recovery concept and what are the two techniques of database recovery. Before going to start a database recovery, so we must have a basic knowledge about database backup. So database backup is nothing but creating another copy of data to avoid a damage control after the loss or if data is corrupted. Okay, so that process of taking the or creating the another copy of data is called as a database backup. There are basically two types of database backup: physical backup and logical backup. Where in physical backup, a complete data backup is taken in the hard disk or tape or magnetic disk. In the logical backup, only a logical structure of the data is taken into the backup, that is a view, procedure, functions or tables are taken in the backup. And to avoid the loss, to avoid the damage, we required a backup. Now it is our database recovery. So recovery is a general process to restore or roll back the data from the database backup. Okay, it is a process to restore the original data back from the backup is known as a recovery. So database recovery is a process to get a original data back. So it is a opposite process of database backup is called as a database recovery. So we are recovering the data from the database backup. Basically there are two types of database recovery technique: roll back and roll forward technique. Recovery is nothing but periodically we are taking the backup of any database, and if there is a loss of any data, then that data is recovered using the recovery process. A transaction logs, transaction effects, or a transaction before database or after database can be taken into the backup. Okay, so copy of that record is taken into the backup. If there is a problem, we are getting that original copy of data back, which will be before the transaction. So that is a recovery process. In recovery, basically there are two types of recovery: rollback recovery and roll forward recovery. Rollback recovery undoes all the partly committed transaction. If there is an error or there is any cause due to that there will be loss of data, that whole process, whole transaction is rollback. Okay, it will be undo the all the partially committed transactions is called as rollback. Roll forward, redo the transaction by applying after image to the database. The redo is nothing but a small part of that transaction will be backup. Okay, not overall transaction. Okay, ya doni technique madhe far simple technique ahet. Roll back manje kay, purna te transaction cha purvi jasa database hota tasa to recover karne, manje tya purna transaction cha after cha jo ahe ते ट्रांजैक्शन जर फेल गेला असेल तर त्याच्या बिफोर मध्ये जी इमेज होती डेटाबेसची ती रिकवर करून घेणे, म्हणजे ट्रांजैक्शनचा इफेक्ट अंडू करणे. रोल फॉरवर्ड मध्ये जो पार्ट डॅमेज आहे किंवा जो ट्रांजैक्शन जो डेटाबेस डॅमेज करतो तेवढाच पार्ट रिकवर करणे इज कॉल्ड ॲज अ रोल फॉरवर्ड. रोल बॅक, फुल बॅकअप ऑफ दॅट ट्रांजैक्शन. रोल बॅक, पार्टली बॅकअप ऑफ दॅट ट्रांजैक्शन. ओके, सो दीज आर द टू टेक्निक्स: roll back and roll forward. In backup there is another type, log based recovery. So log is nothing but a sequence of record or sequence of activity of user or transaction which having the effect on the database. So logs are records of your transaction activities or a user activity. If there will be any operation causes an error or causes a database damage, that can be avoided using the logs. So logs are stored in the backups, and using the logs we can actually find out which operation is problematic and which damaged the database. Using the logs we can recover the data easily. For that we must start the log using syntax tn start, that is a tn, that is a transaction start. Then there will be some statement and then transaction commit, so in which there are your statements. Okay, so these logs are created using start and commit, and that logs are used to recovery process, which operations are creating the problems are only that part of the data is recovered using the log based. So basically it is a roll forward method. Okay, so log based recovery is roll forward method of data recovery. Next, so log based recovery has two types: deferred database modification and immediate database modification. Deferred database modification technique: if transaction is not modify the database until it is committed. Okay, deferred means what? After the successful committed of that transaction, then there will be logs are created and that logs are used to recovery process. Immediate means if there will be any problem due to the any operation, that operation is captured into the log, and after that specific operation the recovery process is generated. Deferred means after the completion of complete transaction there will be recovery. Immediate means in the current active state the recovery process can be carried out. So these are the two log based recovery methods: deferred and immediate. Deferred means after completion of transaction, and in immediate means in the current active transaction we can have a recovery. Recovery in the concurrent transactions: so if there are multiple transactions on the single database and if they are creating the problems, then there must be a checkpoint concept. A checkpoints are nothing but a point in the transactions are created which are called as a checkpoint. A checkpoint mechanism is a very important to handle a concurrent transaction recovery. A concurrent means a multiple transactions are occurring on the single database and that will damage the database, then that recovery will be based on the checkpoint. This concept is similar to save point. A save point is a point on in the database where your database is a safe state or it will be stored state. So checkpoints are created in the concurrent transaction recovery process. Okay, suppose there are four transactions and already there is a checkpoint created in the transaction number one. If there is a failure due to any transaction, your database is recovered back to the checkpoint. Okay, ekas database var चार ते पाच ट्रांजॅक्शन व्हायला लिहिले आहेत. ट्रान्झॅक्शन नंबर वन आहे की 500 रुपये ॲड केल्यानंतर डेटाबेस कमिट झालेला आहे, तर ती जी स्टेट आहे तो चेक पॉईंट क्रिएट केलेला आहे. त्या चेकपॉईंट नंतर कधीही फेल्युअर आलं तर तुमचा डेटाबेस त्या चेकपॉईंटच्या स्टेटला रिकवर केला जातो. सो दॅट इज अ चेक पॉईंट कन्सेप्ट ऑफ रिकव्हरी. ओके, लॉग बेस्ड रिकव्हरी आहे ती आहे, अँड चेक पॉईंट रिकव्हरी वेन देर आर कंकरंट ट्रान्झॅक्शन्स आर ऑकर. Okay, so how to create a checkpoints? Basically there are two lists are created in the checkpoints. So there is a undo list and redo list. So undo is nothing but abort the changes which created by that transaction. Okay, if recovery system logs are found, then it is started with start and commit, or in the just commit. Okay, so it will be abort all the changes which is specified in the undo list. Redo list means what? A redo list start with the transaction statement TN start and end with commit. So there is no need of commit there. Okay, so redo list means a part of the transaction which is not corrupted, which is not affected, having the effect, and that redo list will be implemented. So in the checkpoint there are two lists, undo list and redo list. Okay, so these are the two basic concepts in the concurrent recovery, undo list and redo list. Basically, my dear students, we have discussed this in the previous unit in save point. Okay, we are saving the transaction at the specific point and we are roll back. For this we can have an example. Suppose you have a transaction at the ATM. Okay, you have inserted your card, you have inserted amount, you have inserted appropriate pin, and your transaction is completed. Due to the network failure, cash is not out, but your balance is deducted. Okay, actually money is not out, but cash is not from that user, cannot get the cash, but balance is deducted 500 or 10,000 rupees. Okay, तुम्ही 10,000 withdraw करायला लागलाय, withdraw ची process complete झाली, card टाकलेला आहे, pin टाकला, okay, connection झालं, transaction complete झालं, money out of the ATM आलं नाही, तुमच्या account मध्ये पण deduction झालं, तर काय होतं? So that will be a damage of your database. It will be recovered. Okay, checkpoint केलेला आहे कुठं, की cash जर out झाली नाही तर after the 24 hours your balance will be recredited back. So that is a checkpoint concept. Okay, so there will be checkpoint, money is out from the box or not. If money is not out, then your balance is as it is. So after the 24 hours you can get your balance back. So that is a system which is be used in the banking. So that is a recovery. So recovery is nothing but getting a data back from the database. If data backup, if there is a problem or there is a failure in the database or there is a damage in the database due to the any failure or due to the any transaction, if there is no data or there is no any consistency in the data, then that data will be taken from the backup. So that is the concept of data recovery. Okay, so these are the very simple concept in the unit number 5, and from this video lecture there will be 4 marks question. What are the different types of recovery technique? Basically there are two techniques, roll back and roll forward technique. Write down your notes with the proper example of roll back and roll forward technique. Okay, so it will be last lecture of unit number 5 and it will be end of your syllabus. Okay, so it is very easy unit. You can have a maximum marks from the unit number 5. Okay, still then, stay at home, stay safe, happy learning.